JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February the 25th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It lost the most ground versus NOK, NZD, AUD and CAD in that order, while it gained only against the Japanese yen. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the pound and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakness in the safe havens yen and franc, combined with the strengthening of the commodity-linked currencies Aussie, Kiwi and Luni, suggests that the markets turned risk on yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU indices were a sea of green, with investors' appetite rolling over and even strengthening during the US and Asian sessions. It seems that EU indices rebounded and traded in the green after data showed that Germany's economy grew 0.3% quarter over quarter instead of 0.1% as the initial estimate suggested. The boost during the US and Asian sessions may have been the result of Fed Chair Powell's testimony before the House Financial Services Committee. The Fed chief reiterated his dovish stance, adding that it may take more than 3 years for inflation to reach the Fed's goals, and that they will look beyond any temporary spike in prices. This is in line with the minutes of the latest FOMC meeting, in which it was noted that inflation was projected to overshoot 2% for some time in the years beyond 2023, and that any move above 2% beforehand is likely to prove to be temporary. Powell's remarks suggest that monetary policy is likely to stay extra-accommodative for longer than many market participants have been expecting, and adds more credence to our view for a supported market appetite. We stick to our guns that the retreat due to rising bond yields and inflation concerns may have been just a corrective phase. We still believe that the extra loose monetary policy around the globe, the progress in the COVID vaccination race, and the large fiscal package in the US are a blend of developments that could prove supportive for the broader investor morale. This means that equities may continue to trend north, while safe havens like the yen and franc may stay under selling interest. Other risk-linked assets like the commodity-linked currencies of the Kiwi and Luni may benefit as well, with the Kiwi receiving extra support from the RBNZ's projection of higher interest rates in December. As for the US dollar, Powell's dovish remarks are likely to keep it pressured for a while more. Now, as for today's events, Thursday's agenda is relatively light. We only get the second estimate of the US GDP for the fourth quarter, the durable goods orders for January, the pending home sales for the same month, and the initial jobless claims for last week. The second GDP estimate is forecast to reveal a minor revision to 4.1% quarter over quarter from 4%, while durable goods orders are expected to have accelerated to 1.1% month over month from 0.5%. However, the core rate is anticipated to have declined to 0.7% month over month from 1.1%. Pending home sales are expected to have slid 0.1% month over month after declining 0.3% in December, while initial jobless claims are forecast to have declined somewhat to 838,000 from 861,000. Tonight, during the Asian morning Friday, Tokyo CPIs for February are coming out, with the core rate expected to have held steady at minus 0.4% year over year. No forecast is currently available for the headline rate. Japan's preliminary industrial production and retail sales for January are also due to be released. Industrial production is forecast to have rebounded 4% month over month after a 1% slide in December, while retail sales are expected to have fallen 2.6% year over year after sliding 0.2% in December. As for the speakers, today we will get to hear from ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos, ECB Executive Board Member Philip Lane, New York Fed President John Williams, and Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic. Tonight, during the Asian Morning Friday, RBNZ Governor Adrian Orr will step up to the rostrum. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.